Guys, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll show you how can you make your very own Variac transformer, which can be used in quite a lot of applications. But before we start, shall I warn you all that this is quite a dangerous device to make. So if you are planning to repeat this project, it will be done at your own risk, so be aware. With that out of the way, the name Variac stands for Variable Auto Transformer, and we will do just that in this video using, well, obviously a transformer. A Variac has a different form and shape, but usually the common one is made using a Torelda transformer. There are some Variacs out there which they are E and I shape metal sheets, but they are a bit harder to make, so I'll be focusing on a Torelda type transformer. Here I have a off-the-shelf Torelda Variac, but this one has only 3 connections, which means that the output is not isolated. That's why I want to make mine a bit safer. Here I have a little prototype of a Variac. This is a normal Torelda transformer, on which I have scraped the isolation on few parts here and there of it to expose the bare copper underneath. As you can see, it's working as expected, the halogen lamp having different light intensity when I move it around on the toroidal core. Now with that out of the way, I'll be starting to remove his secondary winding, because the toroidal secondary output of this particular transformer is only 12 volts or 13.5 without any load. Now there are some formulas to calculate the output voltage, but for this size of the transformer I got here, it will be over 300 turns for this Variac. I'll not be needing the full 220 or 250 volts anyway. Now if you are interested to know how many turns it will require to give 220, I will show you, but after I'll be removing the secondary coil, and after a few moments I got the secondary coil removed from the core of the transformer. And now it is the time to calculate to see how many turns it will be taking first. First we measure the outside dimension of the toroidal transformer. In this case I got my toroidal external diameter of about 94 mm or 9.4 cm. Then we have to check the inner dimension, and it is roughly 36 mm or 3.6 cm. Now after we know these two, we have to measure the height. That comes about to 36 mm or 3.6 cm. And now after I got all of them, let's start the calculation. First we add 9 cm minus 3 cm equals 6 cm. Then 6 times 3 equals 18 cm. After 18 divided by 2 equals 9 cm, which is the equivalent area of the core. These results are not 100% accurate due to the reason we got already an existing coil of wire around the core. After dividing 42 divided by the cross section of our core, which is 9 cm, in this case we get a voltage per turn of 0.214 volts. Now if the calculation is right, we should have around over 500 turns for getting 250 volts times 2. Now onto rewinding the core. For that I'll be using the salvage wire from the secondary of the core. I know it is a bit tangled, but I have my own to solving that. Then I jump on 1-to-3D design and made a little jig for the wire. Then I have sliced it in Cura, and after I insert the SD card on the printer, it will start to print. That was done to make the winding of the transformer a bit easier, and here I got the jig ready to use. Now I'll be starting to add the MLED wire onto the plastic spool. Before winding I have to first untangle the wire. Now I have used a little plier to untangle the untangable section of the wires. Then after a bit of fight, it was finally giving up. After I got the first side done, I can start adding it to the Torelda core. I start winding the core slowly, making sure that the wire will not overlap, because if the wire will overlap, I will be using a portion of the final voltage at the end, when I will be done winding it. The winding took some time due to the thickness of the wire, but still I was somewhat manageable. Now after I had wind half the core, you can have a closer look at my professional factory winding. Is somewhat okay-ish. Let's move further. After the half of the wire was spooled onto the toroidal, I took the other half and winding it onto the jig. And after I start removing the coating from the wire, then I solder the two halves together and process further with the winding. And like that, the other half has been winded. After I finish winding the transformer, let's test it. Now as you can see, I am getting about 24 volts AC, which is not much, but still it's okay, because the original voltage of transformers was 2 times 12. Now I will be scraping the MLED coating and probe for a different voltage. As you can see, I am getting a bit over 11, so that means the rewind of the transformer was successfully. Now I have designed some 3D parts and 1-to-3D design. The first one will be the centerpiece, on which all the remaining parts will be mounted. After slicing it, I start the printing process for the filament. I use, like I used before, the orange PLA Plus. For the layer height, I use 0.2 mm with an infill of around 20% and a wall count of 2. After printing it, we got the piece in about 1 hour and 20 minutes. Then after removing the brim from the part, we can install it onto the transformer. But before that, I have printed another part, and this part is just to provide a better weight distribution of the transformer and allowing it to stay a bit cooler when it's in use. Yes, the parts can be printed at once, or you can print them individually. But if I was doing like that, where was all the fun? and figuring it all out to begin with it. Now I have designed another piece which will be for holding a 608 bearing, which will allow for the last piece to be able to sweep around more easily. The part is done as well in 1-2-3 design, and after printing it we got it. The part is done. Now before assembling it all up, I have to add an 8mm screw into the middle, that will be for screwing the variact. After that I have added the bearing assembly, starting first by screwing it down. Then the last part which will hold the bearing assembly and security them as well with 3mm screws. Now here I have designed and printed another part. This will be for going over the bearing, and it will serve as an arm which will allow the variact to be adjusted, and doing so the voltage will increase and decrease depending where the sweeping arm is located onto the variact. But this is still a prototype, so next I have designed and printed more parts like the sweeping arm, the middle support because we need to make some extra room for the parts. Now I'll be removing the existing arm, but before installing the good one on top, I have removed it as well, the inner part which will hold the two sides of the variact together. Then I took a metal disc, and after I have clamped it down in my little vise, I have grabbed my grinder and went to town to make a perfect hole, because the metal disc has an indentation and drilling that out with a sapping bit wasn't working. This part is quite important. After I have sanded the metal disc, which turned out pretty much as I was expecting, let's do a test fit, and it fits perfectly as you can see. After that I have drilled a little 4mm hole in the disc, then I got some wires and cut them to size. Then I have removed the metal disc from the printer parts and soldered the wire, then added it back. Then I have installed the 608 bearing with the help of a little vise. This was quite a rough battle to get it in. And then I installed back all the parts onto the variac, as you can see it starts to look like one. The next process was to connect the metal disc to the brush by help of a little brush L shape. After flattening them out with a plier, I have grabbed a AAA battery and removed the graphite rod from in and snapped it in half. Then I have added a little spring along with a washer, then I have installed the brass bracket with the 3mm screws. Now it's ready for the tip. For the tip as well I was thinking to use as well some brass metal in combination with a metal screw, but it turned out to not be a great idea, so I was thinking to try something different this time. After repeating the bearing part again but slightly modified, I have taken a carbon brush from an old AC non-working motor which I was having lying around and designed another piece which will hold it in place. Now let's assemble it back. And with the last part sorted, we can finally test it. Now as you can see, the variacs work as intended. The voltage can be adjusted from 0 to nearly 25 volts AC. The rotating part of the variac is somewhat decent. The voltage swings around good. Now what will do if I need more voltage? Well, it's simple, I will be using another transformer. Like this one I have here, it is a 12 volt step down main voltage transformer. Like that I'll have 2 layers of isolation. And with the external transformer I can get the full 220 if I will ever need it so. Now this variac can output only AC at this moment in this configuration, but by adding a full bridge rectifier we can convert it to output DC. This is mostly to power DC loads and as well to charge up car's battery if I will need it so. In the end I have printed more parts for it, like the fits and then a platform which will contain the variac, and I will be using it at a 24 volts auto transformer due to the safety concern. But now it's time to say goodbye. This was quite an exciting project. Detail regarding the project along with all the files can be found in the video description section. I will see you all in my next video. Till then have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya.